choose to take the Oligan out and not if it's Tyria and why?
Oh, that's a long time ago. It was even much before we had the first prototypes. And the idea was to understand, okay, what is possible with this OLED technology. What we knew is that we will get very homogeneous light. That was very interesting then for our styling. Also, that it was that there was a possibility to make it really flat. And when we started, I think you remember the Swarm. It was a three-dimensional, I would say, the complete rear of the car. And it was one big display and all these functions were moving. That was actually the original vision that our styling guys had when I told them, yes, we can do something with OLEDs. And that was actually then the idea to say, okay, how can we get from this flat, easy thing actually to something three-dimensional? And that's actually the what you can see here. We have this dynamics and all of this, it's already now, that's what we have here. That was one part of the vision, and the other part of the vision was, of course, we wanted flexible, because for styling guys, it's actually normally it's totally terrible to have something flat, two-dimensional. But as you can see, even with two-dimensional, it's possible to get something really nice and unique.
What is the advantage of a flex OLED? Why do we need something like this?
With this flexible OLEDs, the big advantage, as you can see, you can fit it a bit more to the contour and the surfaces of our cars. And of course, the big vision would be, okay, take it on the rear, glue it on there, and that's it. Maybe in a few years we also get something like this, and then we have a complete foil on the rear of the car. Maybe it's a big objective for the future.
So as you curve the thin glass or whatever flexible substrate around the end of the car, what are some of the benefits that you get by using OLED as you curve that device around the car, other than just the fact that it curves? Why is it important to have a thin light source that does it?
Actually, for us, the intention of our rear lights is actually that we say, okay, we want not just a one-way direction of communication. We want communication attraction in every direction. And because it's a surface emitter, you need then to get light in all directions. And that's very important, because the communication actually is completely around the car. It's on the floor. On the floor, it's not with OLED, it's with projection systems. But on the car, it's we use these surface emitters, and it's actually the one big thing that we need. So it's just because we have to go around the car, and you need some technologies that are able to go around the car.
So the communication is an incredible idea, and then I think the segmentation allows you some diversity of that. What type of communication are you thinking you want to give to people behind the car?
The main thing is, of course, safety information, because our cars are connected. We know, we have much more information from our navigation system. We have information from other cars. The cars are communicating via Wi-Fi. So we know something that's happening in the form, and we can give this information to other cars that don't have this car-to-car communication. But we can give this information to them, and we can save lots of seconds. And if you can save one second of reaction time, it's totally great. And we could save many seconds by just giving this information to other cars behind us. And that makes life safer for our drivers, but also for the drivers behind of us. So it's safety for all. And that's something that's it's possible with this communication items, and that's why it's something that we try to push.
And OLED is a good technology for that because of the segmentation?
OLED is, at the moment, it's perfect. It's the only thing where we get the intensity, where we get a nice look, and where we can do all of this. And of course, we need the segmentations. And as you can see here, the segments are very good for communication. We can give warnings. We can give all of this, and this all with a high brightness and with a really nice look. And of course, nobody pays for safety. To combine this with styling is then the perfect combination, so that we can bring this technology into the cars. Although nobody would buy it, but because of the styling ideas, the people will buy it. Yeah.